Firstly, I want to thank the Center for Middle East Studies for inviting us to speak with you, and I really appreciate to be here. At the beginning, I want to show a short movie in accordance with Syrian refugees.
Can you close it?
Something needs to be done. Something needs to be done about the incomplete lives, hopes turned to dust for the victims of the war causing inexpressible pain. Something should be done for the ones leaving their beloved ones, homes, children, jobs, friends, and lives behind, hitting the roads. As Turkey, we have been struggling to relieve these pains from the very first day. We are working for them, but more has to be done. Because we want the whole world to notice them. We want them to rebuild their shattered lives. Suffering of these victims of war, because we want all human beings to enjoy a humane life. Afad.
Now I will give you some general information about Syrian refugees. As a result of the civil war in Syria, more than 500,000 people died. 13.5 million people out of 20 million people became needy or indigent of humanitarian aid. 6.3 million people were displaced and 4.9 million people left their homeland and became refugees. This flow of asylum seekers, this migration wave affected mostly Turkey. The migration wave started on the 29th of April 2011. As 300 Syrians applied to Turkey in seek of asylum, and as from the year 2015, Turkey became the country that holds the highest number of refugees of the world. Today, 3,412,368 Syrians are under temporary protection in Turkey. 3/5 of these people left their homeland due to security issues, and half of them entered Turkey through an illegal boundary point. Turkey acted according to the principle of non-refoulement and placed the asylum seekers under temporary protection. On the year 2013, the law concerning the foreigners and international protection was passed and the Directorate General of the Migration Management was formed. Everything from their legal status to their residence permit is determined by the law. And the interventions were carried out on the basis of rights via a holistic approach to the regulations concerning temporary protection. A truly young population is in seek of various rights and services in Turkey today. 40% of 3.5 million Syrians in Turkey are under the age 18. Approximately 1 million Syrians are school-age children. It's impossible to handle such a group casually or accidentally. All the effort will be superficial unless all the circumstances, needs, and resources are determined properly. This fact manifests the importance and the necessity of social work. On the other hand, no country can be ready for 3.5 million refugees, nor Turkey was. Given these circumstances, it is necessary to generate efficient, fair, and fast solutions by taking the hierarchy of needs into consideration. It's obvious that in order to fulfill the social functionality of the individual, his or her social needs must be satisfied. It's impossible to put forth an efficient intervention just by satisfying physiological needs. On the other hand, it is hard to put other needs to forefront without satisfying physiological needs. In this context, it is better to talk about temporary refugee shelters, where the sheltering, nutrition, and safety needs are taken care of. Temporary shelters are camps that focus on basic or fundamental needs. However, there are still ongoing works that aim at maintaining normal lifestyle. There are education services for each and every children, including preschool activities. In adult shelters, there are shopping, heating, security, communication, and interpretation services along with its infrastructure. Children-friendly areas, youth workers, and lifelong public education centers. There are also psychological supports, laundry, dishwashing units, cleaning, education, and vocational course activities, rest centers, child parks, TV, and internet services. In 21 shelter camps, distributed among 10 cities, there are 27,934 shelter tents and 30,900 belonging container houses. 228,489 Syrians live in these shelters that are called the camps. However, this number covers only 9% of Syrians seeking asylum in Turkey. The rest, the remaining 93%, live outside these temporary shelters. Entries and sorties are restricted in camps due to the security-related reasons. Recent research shows that despite the fact that circumstances are tougher outside, shelter inhabitants find living inside the camps boring and depressing. They seek deliverance because they feel like losing their freedom. The ones that choose living inside the camps make that choice due to the security-related and economic reasons. Current perception. Not only individuals, but also their customs, culture, and lifestyle translocate via migration. Current sociocultural structure enlarge as the new sociocultural elements that the asylum seekers bring along settle. Therefore, in order to increase the efficiency of the intervention, the problem of harmony or adaptation must be solved. The time adaptation essentially implies not only the newcomers' participation, but also the inhabitants' acceptance of the other. At first, local people show positive attitude towards immigrants due to the religious imperatives, such as help the needy or love the neighbor. However, the rights given to them, the duration of their accommodation or residence, the increasing volume of their population and of their demands made local people regard Syrians as a risk concerning the access to the rights and resources. Real reasons, such as increase in real estate prices and unemployment rates, and also their access to basic needs for free consolidated, this hostile perception about Syrian asylum seekers. The ideal ones, such as their acceptance to higher education without examination, increasing rates of crime, their being obstacle to the economic development, also reinforced this hostility. Moreover, Syrians appear on media if and only if they face or cause problems. Addressing Syrian people as a homogeneous group of needy and unhappy people affects the locals' perception about the Syrian. Thus, society keeps on enhancing the position of the other. Second generation is targeted within the supports concerning social adaptation, as they maintain their own culture within their families. The children are included to the education system. in order for them to become familiar with the new local culture. On the other hand, there is still work to do to increase the cultural tolerance of the local developers. To prevent the risk of lost generation, there is need for synergic or collective work that brings the administrators, teachers, students, and their families. Fundamentals of the social work intervention towards refugee children. Social work helps people reveal their own functionalities within their own social environment. To do so, it regulates the social environment. By providing social change, by supporting intercommunal relationships, by enhancing problem-solving skills, it strengthens the individual. Social work tries to maintain the well-being and the deliberation of the individuals. Human rights and social justice are the pillars of social work. 2 points require attention in dealing with asylum seekers. The fact that they are not a homogeneous group of uniform people, and the fact that they are displaced people that left their economic, cultural, and social backgrounds behind. Taking care of refugee children. One must mind their needs varying by age. In order to maintain their developmental rights, their biopsychosocial needs must be satisfied. Age till 5. These children need affection and to be with their families. In this period, children do not want to be away from their families even for a short while. This fact, we close the monitoring of their health and socialization. Refugee children have access to children-friendly areas from the age 4 onwards. In these areas, social workers try to support children via various activities and help them develop their fundamental skills such as motor skills and hygiene. Recent research shows that most of the preschool teachers working with refugee children claim that the biggest problem concerning these children is the language, that is Turkish language skills, of course. A child without language skills cannot express himself or herself in the classroom and face a new problem in their language. Children's problems concerning language skills remains unsolved. This may be due to the fact that neither authorities nor asylum seekers' families believe that their stay in Turkey would be perpetual. All to the good, lately, there are some efforts to solve this problem. Age 6 to 10. This is the period where children develop role models and participate in education. Education is crucial in making role models. It's crucial also in biopsychosocial development of children. Teachers are steeped in helping children develop role models. Syrian asylum seekers that are registered have the right to access education services. The children with temporary education ID cards or alien registration ID cards are eligible to attend Turkish schools. However, some families do not want to get registered either because they seek UN official refugee status, or because they expect to go back soon, or because they are afraid their children will be assimilated. In these cases, children remain out of education system. In some cases, children deny participating in education due to the adaptation issues. Recent research manifests the negative effect of Turkish authorities, teachers, parents, and students on Syrian children's journey to education. Turkish students deny growing friendship with their Syrian compeers. Authorities deny their responsibility and teachers use language problem as an excuse. In such a social environment, Syrian children deny going to school. In camps, nearly 90% of children attend school. Outside the camp, the percentage is just 25% because of these social factors. Syrian children do not only attend Turkish regular schools. There are more diverse schools that follow revised Syrian curricula in Arabic. temporary education centers. These schools were serious parents' preference, and they were providing immediate solution. However, in accordance with the principle of uniform education in Turkey, these centers are getting closed and becoming subject to Turkish government's uniform education system. Instead of these centers, Turkish government supports Syrian Arabic language courses for Syrian children that attend Turkish schools in order for them not to become alienated from their own culture. Another determining factor concerning the psychological development of children between age 6 to 10 is peer relations. Syrian children have limited opportunity to build up friendship because of spatial and cultural change. Families with bad traits send their children to school, but they do not have the means to provide the concern and circumstances for a healthy education. Children falling short of their needs shy away from their peers and from their school. Traumas in such circumstances may cause various behaviors. Some children may behave in a mature way and share the burden on the shoulders of their family. Some children may internalize violence and reproduce it. Children's support centers are founded in order to provide psychological backup for the children between the age 6 to 18. In these centers, there are some efforts or activities that include the classmates and neighbors of Syrian child to build up peer relations. These efforts aim at strengthening the child within his or her own social environment. In this way, both the child's social environment grows and the prejudice of the local dwellers weaken thanks to the cultural exchange. 12 to 18 age group points out adolescence period. In this age, children behave with the desire to transcend border and authority. It's an important developmental factor that the future is predictable in these age groups. Waiting for an indefinite future, unpredictable experiences negatively affect the children. Boring expectation creates feeling of lack of trust and insecurity. Therefore, while working with this age, the social worker must fulfill the task of giving information. Due to the rioting and opposition to authority, the success of children in school may reduce in this period. Various studies have been carried out to prevent this situation. In this period, the opportunity of leading is given to the children. Opportunities are provided for them to perform themselves. The children who have completed their comprehensive process are helping to the other asylum-seeking children, child support centers, as a community volunteers. It is important that children who know the problem better and who have experienced the mechanisms of coping become actors in this matter. In addition, group work is carried out on the issues such as trust, future planning, and problem solving. In this way, the children realize that they are not alone in their experiences and that their problems can be solved. This period also poses risks at the point of the child labor. With both economic reasons and the willingness to resist authority, the children can go for the employment. Achieving the academic issues is important to prevent the child labor. Instead of working in a criminal-focused manner, the child labor is trying to be prevented with the understanding of the source of the problem and with the substitution of different coping mechanisms. At the end, children cover half of the Syrian refugee population. According to official records, 224,750 babies were born in Turkey and 14% of Syrian women are pregnant. The duration of being a refugee is approximately 20 years. Considering this large period of time, social work becomes very important for Syrian refugee children. Education is essential for children. we cannot tolerate a lost generation. Moreover, maintaining social functionality of refugee children is crucial. Only within the education system we can reach children. Only within the education system we can strengthen them, and only within the education system we can provide their adaptation, so that we may maintain harmony within the new blended society. Every kind of support may be provided, from physiological needs to self-actualization. Access to refined education is necessary for personal success. But that is not all. For the welfare of both Turkey and Syria, education must be in the center of both national and international policies. No doubt, these children have experienced traumatic events. They witnessed tragic events all before, during, and after the migration. Despite all difficulties, these strong children keep on struggling to survive. Their strengths and skills must be taken into consideration.